He speaks the facts.
You don't do them. And the reason isn't because you're not going to ever do them. It's because you're going to do them, but just later. You're going to start that next time. And that's your own brain trying to protect you from failure. The choice, the decision that they're talking about is choosing to push past that. To build on that, once you can consistently make that choice, and so that you know, you have 5 fucking seconds to make that choice. And then it gets real hard. After 5 seconds, the brain has shitted chemicals everywhere that have stopped your body from moving. So you have 5 seconds before that chemical process takes place. Everybody thinks that thoughts are transferred just electrically. No, there is a chemical process that trails that electrical communication. So your cardiovascular, your circulatory, your respiratory, all these different systems build. Hear the word fuck. Self-preservation kicks in. And you're like, all right, the next time somebody says fuck, I'll do it. You have 5 seconds to get down on the ground and do your 100 push-ups. If you do, you beat the chemical process. If you do that often enough, in fact, there's actually a time period. And the average is 21 days. So the first 10 days, it's really hard. After 15 days, it becomes kind of normal. And after 21 days, on average, give or take a few, it's just who you are. Every time you hear fuck, you're going to do 100 push-ups. It's just who you are. It's just the way that you are now. You have built those pathways through your brain. Your brain now knows it doesn't have to protect you from that notion. It knows it can allow your consciousness to make this a physical reality at any given moment, and it won't harm you. You're not going to fail. So self-preservation has no place here.